Agent 47 and Diana Burnwood are the world's top assassins working for the ICA. Unknowingly, they have been hired by a shadow client to target a number of operatives of Providence, a secret organization working in the highest echelons of power. Providence's controller, the Constant, approaches Diana and makes her a deal. Eliminate the shadow client and learn about 47's past. But when 47 discovers that the shadow client is Lucas Gray, his lost childhood friend, he and Diana switch sides to fulfill an old pact. Destroy Providence. Together, they manage to capture the Constant, forcing him to reveal the identities of the three Providence partners. Eliminate them, and the war would be over. However, the Constant has an ace up his sleeve. Look closer. In the shadows, behind the everyday world, beyond the headlines and the seats of power, a hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable, the unforgivable, and it never gave us a second thought. Until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learned the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base. Lexa Carlyle's helicopter just took off. Confirm target locations, over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlyle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free. And since then, he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlyle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth-generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, So Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
Right. This is our moment, 47. Providence ruined our lives with the flick of a pen. Today, we return the favor. Happy hunting.
Welcome to Dubai, 47. Today is the inauguration of the scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
Come in. 47, do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here. The inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
as all of you know, I am from one of the less privileged sides of the respectable
On behalf of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali, I bid you welcome to this
I would like to thank my cousins, without whose friendship and influence this achievement might. Thank you. I'm proud to yet again aboard this great too.
Listen, I want to talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. Right there. That's Marcus Stuyvesant, Providence's partner, self-entitled and arrogant little worm. He might not look like much, but he's done more damage to the world than you could dream.
If everything fails, then you get me. This is my day, and I pay you to make sure I can enjoy it. Yes, good. Now off you go. I have important
things. Hey, stay safe.
Guard turned up yet?
We still haven't heard from him yet. But we know he's in the building. I'm sure he's just waiting for his uniform. He'll be up soon.
I'm glad to hear, but I don't like to be kept waiting. Make sure he has his papers and call me, okay?
I'll call you as soon as he turns up.
Good. And please, when I come back, no more excuses. I'm a personal friend of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali.
just a drink. You don't mind, do you? Oh, I really think you are putting on a brave face. You shouldn't be hiding back here. You should be out there celebrating life. Oh, no, that reminds me. I have to go to talk to Richard Potter. You know, I'm really frightened of him. His review on the census exhibition was brutal. But I'd rather be here supporting you.
It's really sweet of you, but I'm...
Oh, don't be silly. I'm here for you. But, you know, I also do want to talk a little shop. I have an idea for the next exhibition. You are gonna love it.
Lucy, seriously, can you please give me half an hour alone? I need to think.
I know you feel alone, but you have to understand you are not. I'll always be here for you. Oh, look over there.
You got him, 47. Marcus Stuyvesant won't be a problem anymore. Let's move on to Carl Ingram. We're not done yet.
There.
How are you?
Think these elevators are ever gonna work right?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm sure all of the well-paid and ethically treated contractors who built this place will be back any day now to take a look.
Well, I can't expect people to take the stairs all the time. Who's gonna want to come to a building this tall
sir.
Highness has never complained about it before.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Ingram, who is the Royal Highness,
you on duty tomorrow?
Yeah. Why?
Just wondered if you got the briefing on the lockdown drill tomorrow.
I got it. I'll get issued one tomorrow morning.
Ruby. You know how it works? Because I don't.
It's easy. Two of us are stationed up here and below, by the card reader. We get an alert, we both swipe our cards, and bingo, lockdown.
What if the other guard is using bathroom?
Well, it's time. So if that should happen, I should be able to run down and activate the other swipe as well. But I guess that will need a little practice.
Happy to not be at work tomorrow. We've got a lot of running around. One more thing to do. Yeah, it'll probably never happen. Just like fire drills.
Yeah. Just like fire drills.
Is there any other blood-sucking germless down there?
Carl Ingram, Providence partner and brass balls billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
Okay, Roland. To my successor. Power is not to be taken for granted. Where many have failed.
Complete rush. So glad we are up here instead.
Ah, sir. Hello.
Looking good today, sir.
Please stay back.
All right, time for a drink.
Spot.
Make me another.
But of course, sir. Coming right up.
Good man.
recruiting. Now, only a fool would assume that power can be kept by only a few good men. Well, and women.
Out of my way, waiter.
Yeah, you know the guest, grumpy one, always wants peace and quiet. Yeah, I haven't seen him playing golf today. He must be in a good mood.
Don't tempt fate. I don't think I've ever worked with a man who could get to such a state.
See, my neighbor always complained about noise. He pissed me off big time.
What did you do?
Well, I kicked his door in, put a gun in his face, told him if he didn't like noise, he'd pack his
shit out of the desert. That was a bit brutal. Hello? Did he move?
Nah, he's my brother-in-law. My wife persuaded him to stay.
Sounds cozy.
Okay, rolling. And Jeffrey excelled. Lo and behold, he started to gain, an idealist, and he started working for what he believed was a greater cause. Fate, however, felt he would be more useful in the private sector and set itself out to lure him with working for the hand that fed him. Grooming is fate's own image when he was needed. Thank you.
believe that it was due to his brilliance, but that fate had dealt him such a deadly hand. Okay.
We got him, 47. Soon there will be no more Providence. You need to find an exit. Our business is done here, but it's far from over.
that's your winning face, I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the Constant.
Nah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once, we can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did,
she'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlisle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this. All of it.
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
You had me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.